And the work done during adiabatic compression is W4, which is equal to integration from 4 to 1. Look at this, 4 to 1. We are completing the cycle. We are going from volume V4 to V1, right? So for V4 to V1 and integration of PdV, it comes out to be minus CV times T2 minus T1. If you compare the equation number 2 and equation number 4, you will realize that here is T1 minus T2, here it is T2 minus T1. So if you take out the minus sign common in this equation, what you will get? T2 minus T1. So W2 will be the minus time W4. Hence W2 will cancel out W4. Therefore total work done, which is the combination or in fact addition of W1, W2, W3 and W4, becomes W, and it will be equals to like this, right? So W2 and W4 will cancel out each other. We'll do some sort of mathematics in this equation. Two steps are there. This is simple mathematics, that is why I'm skipping the steps. And you will get the total work done W is equal to R times T1 minus T2 into log of V2 by V1. Now, it is well known to you that efficiency of any material is nothing but the output upon input. So Q1 minus Q2 is nothing but the amount of work done, that is output, and Q1 is the amount of heat supplied to the system, which is nothing but the input. So output upon input comes out to be W is equal to, output is what? This is work done, right? Our work done is nothing but the output. So output is equal to, so this one, and input is nothing but the RT1 times log of V2 by V1. This is nothing but the isothermal expansion, right? The amount of heat supplied to the system. This is what we have seen previously. So total efficiency of the machine, that is output upon input, comes out to be eta times T1 minus T2 upon T1, which is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. Now if you look at the expression, last expression, you will find that this is 1 minus T2 by T1. So when T2 upon T1 is equal to 0, then only efficiency of any material will be equals to 1, means 100%. Otherwise, it will be always lesser than 1, that is less than 100%. So this is how Carnot has finally proved that the efficiency of any material or any engine cannot be 100%. And it will always be lesser than 1, that is lesser than 100%, right? So this is all about the Carnot cycle. We are stopping over here. So keep in touch, keep subscribing our channel. Thank you so much from Dr. Amesh Taikar. Thank you once again.